In this video, I'll walk you through some high-level information about what an encoder is, some use cases for using it to live stream, and some basics on how to set one up. Streaming with an encoder is a great option for more highly produced live streams that require a more polished experience for viewers. Okay, so what is an encoder? An encoder bridges the gap between your video content and YouTube. Essentially, an encoder converts your video content into a compressed format that can be sent to YouTube for playback on your channel. Some encoders are software applications on your computer, while others are standalone hardware. Note that although some components are standard, each encoder is slightly different and has different capabilities. For a list of YouTube verified encoders, be sure to check out this Help Center article linked in the description below. An encoder requires more equipment and setup than mobile or webcam streaming. So why would you use it? Well, an encoder lets you share your screen and broadcast your gameplay, use external cameras and microphones, use multiple audio tracks, or add special effects on screen, like using third-party tools and integrations to create on-screen pop-ups. Stream with multiple remote participants, for example by using screen sharing software, and manage an advanced production with multiple cameras, video inputs, microphones, and media assets. Again, remember that each encoder has different capabilities and will require different setup. But now that you have a sense of what encoders let you do and you've checked out the list of verified ones you can choose from in our Help Center, here are some basics that apply to most encoders that'll help you set up the content that feed into yours. Some encoders let you set up scenes, layouts, or shots. Think of these as template arrangements for your content. Scene layouts and shots allow you to change the layout of your camera, screen capture, and other assets that you'd like to display on screen. They're made up of one or more media assets that appear to your viewers, and these assets are called sources. So your next step is to add sources. Any content you choose to display to your viewers would be considered a source within a scene, layout, or shot. This could be things like your webcam, your screen capture like the video game you're streaming, images, graphics, and more. Press the plus symbol to add your new source. Once you've added a source, you can then choose where it shows up on screen. Ensure audio is added. Most encoders will automatically add your desktop sound and default microphone. If using a capture card, you may want to add an extra audio source to ensure that your sound, like gameplay sound, is captured. Audio can be tricky, so make sure you test everything out. Testing will help you make sure that the audio captured from your sources is the best it can be. And it'll help you make sure that the media asset isn't too loud or too low in comparison to the others. You might want to add or edit sources to make sure your audio isn't echoing. Adjust your sources. After adding all your sources, adjust them by dragging them on the preview to fit your desired orientation and size. Test everything out. Once everything is set up, test everything out to make sure you know how it looks to viewers. If you're using a software encoder, make sure the computer you're running it on is capable of handling the strenuous task of encoding. You'll also want to test out your internet strength so that you'll get a sense of the stability of the broadcast signal. Finally, check out our recommended encoding specs by going to this Help Center article about encoder settings, bit rates, and resolutions. This will help you see which resolution you should stream at based on your internet strength and give you an overview of recommended settings. From there, you're ready to set up your live stream on YouTube. Check out this video that shows you how to use the live control room and shows you how to connect your encoder to your stream on YouTube. Remember, before you can live stream on YouTube, you'll need to enable your channel for streaming and verify your channel at youtube.com/verify if you haven't already. Note that this verification is different than the verification badges you might see on some other channels. For more info on how to create and manage live streams, watch this playlist and check out the Help Center articles linked below in the description. Thanks for watching.